give them a round of applause. Thank you so much, People Active.
Sleep.
Wow, your parents, are you feeling the energy? Wow, can we give them a hand clap for that wonderful vibe they've just given us? So at this time, we have a great team that is joining us.
Enjoy.
Dear parents, I think that was not enough. Let's give them the very best. Thank you so much. Dear children, God bless you.
welcome to this wonderful day. My name is Atim Shivani. Here is Primary 5 Bright with our contemporary dance. Stay tuned.
Thank you. can't have to sit.
Thank you.
let's clap for those children for the job they have done. And the owner of vehicle number UBH482L, please report to where your vehicle is and sort out a certain issue. Thank you so much. UBH482L.
Matter of fact, shout, baby, when you look, you got a reckon on the way there. You did it so well.
Wow, thank you so much, P4 Sharp, for the wonderful and energetic dance. Dear parents, let's clap this wonderful class, P4 Sharp. Dear parents, at this particular time, let's join our hands and welcome our wonderful head teacher, Miss Agale Godfrey, to speak to us this afternoon. Miss Agale, you're most welcome. I greet you all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We bless the Lord for this day. And I'm so grateful that you are here witnessing the talents exhibited by our young, the little children of both Divine and Zion campus. We welcome you all. And thank you for praying, for sparing your time and a valuable moment. Sorry for that. We welcome you, our dear parents, to this moment. And we thank you for sparing your valuable time to be here with us and witness these young ones exhibit their talent tonight. We are truly excited and that you are witnessing the talent here with us together. And it has been an exciting moment, especially through this term, third term. We have had the joy in the school through the training, through all the talents that we've been developing and nurturing to enable us up to this time. There was a lot of excitement, and I want to appreciate each and every one of you who contributed to making this occasion to be successful as it is. You participated in many ways, and we bless you. We appreciate you, our dear parents, for being part of this show and part of Divine and Zion campus. Our theme for this year is Nurturing People for Victorious Life. And this theme was derived from John 15. It remained the year of the theme. And in this theme, we have three pillars that we cherish. The first one is values. And we, as Victorious, we purpose to raise children of high moral principles based on godly values. And that is what we are seeing here. We also purpose to have academic excellence, and we commit to see to it that our children are supported in great and excellent performance. We work hard to ensure that our children should really perform. And then the third pillar that we have is talent development that you are seeing here. As a school, we intend to develop a wholesome person. We in academics, we strengthen the values, and we also strengthen the hands and skills. That is what you are seeing here. We appreciate each and every one of you for the wonderful contribution you have made us to have a successful concert. May we appreciate ourselves. All this has been because of your prayers, because of your involvement, and may the good Lord reward you. You've given us costumes that made the children so colorful around here, and we appreciate you. In the nurturing of talents, we also have introduced piano lessons that we take the children through, and many have started gaining strength in these activities that we train them in. The other benefits that we see in this concert The first one is it makes school fun. Children are excited. This time round, we don't see children in the sick bay, because when we say that we are going for training, everybody's active. And I think it also plays a big role in the health of the children. Then also, MDD ignites creativity, it ignites critical thinking and teamwork. It also brings in physical fitness. It builds self-esteem and promotes confidence in among these young ones. It's a great way to gain new social skills. It releases stress and decreases anxiety. So let us continue. We join hands together to help these children to continue doing these things that will also help them to earn a living in future. Our baby campus, Zion campus, that is the online campus. You've seen them perform from here. They are very, we plan together, we work together. Whenever your child is there and you feel that the fear is, the distance to Victorious is too far, then the option is the online option. We've had children from India, we have children across the world that we are learning with. And when your child is unable to come to school, just make us know, and we connect you to the link, and your child will be in class. So let us work together to embrace this Zion or the online campus so that we can move on. And as it is said, learning must continue. I heard that from the Zion campus team who were here. This is our new campus, which came to existence during the COVID season. When the schools were closed, the Lord gave our principal a direction that learning must continue. And when majority of the learners were away from school, our learners who were away were in class. So we appreciate the Lord for giving us that wonderful campus. And I encourage you that let us work together and make Zion campus the best campus. Zion campus runs from baby class up to primary 7. Even this year, we have registered candidates who are going to sit PLE, and they started all through in Zion campus. They are online, and they will just come to school on PLE days so that they do their papers. Last year, we had the first lot, and we got children who also got first grade from online. Let's appreciate the Lord for all that. And indeed, learning must continue. We have remaining activities on the term planner. We are not done yet. Much as we are getting towards the end, we still have P7 dedication in Divine Campus at 2 p.m. That is 31st of October 2023. Our candidate parents who are here, we encourage you to come on that day, and we dedicate our candidates to the Lord together. And also, we shall not be done with the candidates on that day. We shall continue praying for them throughout the time when they are doing exams. When you have your altar at home, please, as these children are writing, we shall be on our altars. We shall continue praying for them, and I believe the good Lord will be on our side, and we shall have excellence come 2024 January. Then, we also have a trip for P7. We have this trip, and we have purpose to do it this way, because we are not done yet with the candidate class. We have a way of introducing these children to secondary life. We've looked through experience and realized that children go to senior one when they are not informed, they are not prepared, and some of them get discouraged in senior one or before event time. So we are sparing time. So that we need to take these children through. We need to develop their career. Some children go to secondary when they don't know what they are supposed to do. We need to align them. We introduce them to some career that they are dreaming about, so that some people of substance can talk to them, introducing them into their lives what they are supposed to do if they are to become what they want to be. So we have organized this trip that is yet to come, and we shall go for this trip after PLE examination, and we feel it is very crucial, our dear parents, that you need to release your child. It will be a residential trip for 4 or 5 days where we shall talk into their lives. We go into universities, we go and get some people who can encourage them on what right decision to take. We shall also build their character. We shall inform them on what to do when they go to senior one. We request that we work together to help them so that we release children who are ready to go to senior one. We shall also have PLE break that comes from 7th of November. On 7th of November, we shall be having a briefing for the candidates. Therefore, the rest of the children will remain at home. You will not bring them to school. On 9th and 10th, they will be doing their papers. Then immediately after their papers, on 8th and 9th, sorry, then on 10th, you will bring them to school. From 10th, we shall have 3 to 4 days only to prepare them for end of year or the promotional exams. So we request that immediately after PLE, please bring these children to us so that we can work within those few days to prepare them and push them to the next class. Once again, I want to appreciate each and every one of you who have come to be part of this concert. Thank you so much for listening to me. We are victorious because our God is able. God bless you.
Thank you so much, our teacher, for those wonderful words.
Come on, come on.
to Aglo, we are going to present a creative dance. Please enjoy.
Thank you. created the heavens and the earth.
The parents, the owner of vehicle number UBH 482, please, and the traffic warden to sort out the inconvenience that is happening in the parking lot. Thank you. UBH 482L. Okay, we go on. P3 wise. P3 Agile, let's go on.
Excellence.
you so much, Bikri Ajay. Vehicle number USF865U. Please, we kindly request you go to the parking and you help us. MC, go on.
Victoria's, I'm talking to 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 Victoria's,
Secretariat Education Service is a school that has been in existence for 24 years. They have a kindergarten downtown opposite the former Pride Theatre, where it all started, commonly known as Genesis Campus. As I talk now, Victoria's Education Service is operating in 5 other campuses, namely Miracle Campus, a kindergarten near Bakuli, Divine Campus, accessed via the Victoria's Lane branching of Namirembe Road, an NTED campus that has a kindergarten in Ministers Village in Tinga, Zion Campus, and that is our latest online campus. Last but not least, it's the Ebenezer Campus in Mukono Mbalawa. It is a boarding school for both kindergarten and primary. Jesus Christ is at the center of what Victoria's does. God-fearing and excellence are top values among other values. Loving teachers, respect for children, and valuing parents is what Victoria's does. Yes, I am talking from my experience of 8 years in the school as a student. Well, you can take a child out of Victoria's, but you can't take a Victoria's life out of a child. Vacancies in all classes, in all campuses are available. Looking forward to serving you. We shall be back after a short commercial break. Thank you once again for tuning in. In the interest of time, allow me to introduce our panelists from left to right. Nkisa Paul Daniel, Boseya Esther, Majenda Daniel, Valeria, Peter, Sally Devlin, Mukisa Shama, our interpreter Mirebe Enyana, Afande Kasita Raksham, our dear parent Anisha Bomezi, Achende Spirit. Thank you for accepting to come to this talk show.
Abigail, a little boy told me that you asked your parents to buy for a friend of yours a bottle of water because you observed that she was continuously bringing a clearly clean news dress on your bottle.
I really wonder who told you that. I am not quite comfortable being the center of attention.
Actually, share with us why it bothered you.
My conviction came from the devotion at school about the Good Samaritan. What refused to leave my mind was the truth about your neighbor and the command, love your neighbor is the one in need around you, just like the Good Samaritan in Jesus' parable did. Loving your neighbor is not stopping at feeling sorry, but to go ahead and do something about the plight you observe around you. When I committed since then, I observed around me. When I saw this guy, I knew she needed a bottle. I asked my parents if they could buy her one. I was pleased when they excited talked to a Good Samaritan. It is not about me. It is about loving God by these people.
Wow, such humility. This is truly amazing. Well, Shaza, can you share with us where you get peace despite what is happening in your life?
Wait, what happened in his life?
Well, because my family had, he took our dad. As if that was not enough, my parents' business went. And so my mom, on top of money for our dad, is trying to revive the business. As a family, we made a decision after seeing grieving for our dad the way we were.
What do you mean grieving your dad the way you were?
We will spend time remembering with him, and cried until my mom wanted to go on like this.
I really would like to know how she decided you would do life.
She suggested we see a counselor. Then I remembered her school taught us that the Holy Spirit is a counselor. Now, do not get me wrong. I'm not saying that counselors are not useful. However, in this case, I remembered a verse we had learned at school. It's Psalms chapter 62, verse 8. It says, trust him at all times. You people, pour out your heart to him, for God is our refuge. I encourage my mom and siblings to tell God their pain, and in time, the atmosphere changed. From when I started sharing with God my pain and asking Him to heal me, to give me peace. And that peace from God was that despite my family's circumstances, that is my story.
Now, viewer, we all need to admit that these are amazing children.
I would like to submit, it is God who is amazing. If it were not for Him, I would not be who I am.
Well, I also heard that there is one student whose life just turned around positively. Milen, can you tell us your story?
Well, when I came to this school, I was bad news. I had learned bad habits, but worse than that, I thought those habits were cool. Then I heard my mother and father say that I needed to go to a school that was strong on religion, and it just helped me. I was so sinful on the terrace when I came because of what I heard my parents say. I wasn't willing to change from my bad habits, which I was cool. However, the daily devotions continually challenged my thinking. Hearing that obeying God was a choice, it helped me more than anybody else. Then I thanked the children of Victorious who formed my strength and continually reported me to the teachers. Then my parents took me to the Victorious Children's Spiritual Camp. At that camp, I decided to give my life to Jesus, fully knowing that I needed to let go of those school behaviors. Then, yes, my life's conduct is better. I have better friends, better relationship with my teachers and parents, and better. Yes, there was a positive change in my life.
Just hearing you talk makes me believe that you are a better child. I can't help but wondering what those who have done.
I am not proud of them and would rather not talk about them, lest I become a teacher of bad habits. Let us stick to the positive changes in my life.
That is very interesting. Shall be back after a short commercial break. Do not go away. Talent development is one of the things that Victoria Education Services does. There are still children who like to share with us.
Well, Victorious aims at training Victorious life. One of the values I've acquired is taking an initiative. I am last born, and if you are last born, you get used to being taken care of and thinking for. Everyone in the family is older than you and wants to guide and help you out. Well, when I joined Victorious, they were expecting me to be self-driven. It was a little hard for me. But when I realized that other children of my age were self-driven, I thought twice. I am now diligent in writing my notes and take the initiative to do my homework. My teachers are happy with me and this gives me gas. You know what I mean?
Yes, I know what you mean. Some of you non-conversant with slang, gas means that if teachers and parents' happiness motivate them to continue taking his initiative. At this
question. Victoria, is knowing how to navigate in life no matter what it throws at you.
That's right. I would like to put it this way. Living a victorious life is acquired when you learn to live by the principles of God. God created this one for us. Let us admit, we should know how best His creation operates. So, living together in obedience to God will help one.
Sometimes it's not guidance from
friends, I am that boy. I could not believe it. A boy who I was nothing but mean to was being nice. One day,
God knows him too. And indeed it did. I later learned as he was sharing that Mother Hoping ran both him into him. He was living in obedience to God. To tell you the truth, I wanted to be like him. And I decided I too to live by the principles of God. And now I am happy and easy to get on with child. I am so grateful to you, my friend.
Wow, these children are amazing. Well, the wisdom displayed by these children is mind-blowing. Talking of wisdom, the definition of wisdom that we divide in Victorious is knowing the right thing to do and then going ahead to do it. Can you know that it does not stop at knowing what to do? Wisdom is complete when you know the right thing to do and then you go ahead to do it. Yes, we are right because that's what you become when you live in obedience to God. Wisdom can lead one to a victorious life.
I am a businesswoman. This little victorious child's character has always amazed me. The school bus always drops them near my shop. These children always greet me before proceeding home.
You are right. You are right. This officer and a police always struggle in dealing with children thinking of they are welcome. But I have never had such with a victorious child. I must confess, victorious, you are doing a good job.
I thought I was the only person observing this progress in my child. Indeed, as a parent, I'm amazed at the testimonies. I'm really impressed at what Victorious has done to our children.
Living in obedience to God's word makes you prosper in everything you do. That includes excellence in your education. Obedience to God is the secret behind the success in Victorious Education Service.
I would like to call upon all the panelists to join in our slogan of a victorious child.
You can take a child out of victorious, but you can never take a victorious life out of a child.
This is truly amazing. I now know what it means to live a victorious life.
I have also learned that God's word is a source of wisdom. Because the wisdom displayed by these children is mind-boggling. These children of Primary 5 Active would like to close this talk show with a dance celebrating their victorious life.
Looking forward to seeing you again. Same time, as always, with an interesting program that will not only entertain you, but which word can I use? Edify. Yes, edify. We have been your hosts, Kayongo Kraish
and Anger Chan.
Yes, I request we stand up because we have sat for a long time. It is not healthy. Stand up and stretch a little bit, please. Waist. You can hold your waist and stretch a little bit. It's healthy. Wow, wow, wow. You can take up your seat. Thank you so much. MC.
All that you have seen is because we have a vision, and we have a vision bearer. Victoria's Primary School Divine Campus has organized a special gift for our dear principal, Dr. Barbara Ofono Biondo. We kindly request that Dr. Barbara Ofono Biondo, our dear principal, comes on stage to receive her gift.
This vision. Let us just do what God has called us to do, because He has given us authority to nurture a generation. When you look at these children here, you can't stand back there and say the world is rotten. The future is bright. The outcome that you have seen here on stage, the future is bright. Continue encouraging your children. Continue nurturing them. God has brought their path to victorious because they are world changers. God bless you, dear parents, and for the teachers, I have no words. May God richly bless you, Mr. Gele, with your team. Thank you for pouring out your life and all your time in the children. Thank you so much. God bless you all. We are victorious because God is able. Thank you.
Wow. Dear parents, as we approach the end of the show, I want to prepare you. Don't tell me that I didn't remind you. The team which is coming right here, you better fasten your belt. Are you ready to enjoy? The show is just beginning. You need to clap me.
It's joy that we are here to demonstrate the God-given talent.
Right there in the western part of Uganda, we have a leader center. Let's put our hands together as we welcome Primary 5 Kenya with Shenge tomorrow night.
See you.
Thank you. Nendo ulira kabuwa kamuli ya basoka. Muisuka ya mukulimu wa mukose. Yes, I told you the show is just beginning.
Dear parents, I have a friend here who has danced so well. That is none other than Edrina. Edrina, please come here. Edrina, wherever you are. Dear parents, we want to appreciate you for your support that you extended towards us during the time when Edrina was going through her treatment in India. The girl you saw dancing so well here is called Nachiji Edrina, and she's here. Very strong and very healthy. May God bless you for your support.
Chirugi. Era, 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 era.
Gentlemen, those children deserve a hand clap for the energy they have just displayed at this time. As I told you, the show is just beginning. DJ.
My name is Nara Barenga Wai, and I am
Ladies and gentlemen, I tell you, that is a team with another vibe. Watch.
Thank you.
I told you, we are just beginning.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, P4 Pride, for that wonderful show. See you, friends. Now, dear parents, you cannot come for the concert and you miss to dance. Stand up. DJ, you are giving us the same song, and my lead is here to take us, the parents, through. Your parents, we go up. Everybody, show them. Together the victorious anthem. DJ. The victorious anthem marks our prayer for closing this event. So let's stand in honor of our school and we say the prayer through the anthem. Everybody, I request you raise on your feet as we say this prayer through our anthem. Thank you. We love you so much.
We are beautiful.